Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm Kayla and it's time to crack into a good book. So today's video is going to be my wrap up for the Lord of the Readathons. So I'm going to go in order of the prompts just because, you know, we want to follow my journey through Middle Earth. So the first book I read was Hobbiton, which was Bilbo Taren's 111 Let's Party, Read a Book While Listening to Music in the Background. So for this I chose Spindle and Dagger by J. Anderson Coates. So this I rated 3 out of 5 stars. I think it reminded me very much of a YA version of Juliet Marillier. This is set in Wales in like the 1100s. So this is actually based on real historical events, which I had no idea, and I thought that was like a fun little aspect. So basically our main character Ellen saves a leader of a war band, and she essentially pretends that she's the embodiment of a saint, and says that like this guy has the saint's protection, and it's kind of clever in saying, like, you know, you have to protect me in order to keep this protection. So she, like, kind of has, you know, not a great life. No one's really all that nice to her, and kind of implied and lightly discussed that when the war band raided her home, some of the men raped her, and she's, like, definitely afraid of them. It wasn't discussed in detail. The guy who's in charge of the war band captures the wife of a Norman lord as well as her kids. So Ellen, the main character, like makes friends with her and tries to save them while like deciding what's best for her. So I think this is really a story about survival and kind of like piecing yourself back together. I thought it was like a little slow in parts. I generally enjoyed it. I thought the main character was really intelligent and like I admire her cleverness and, you know, coming up with a way to, like, keep herself alive. I think the author did a really great job of, like, conveying how isolated she was at the beginning of the book, and, like, I really liked watching her journey. It's a little slow in places, for sure, and the plot was maybe, like, a little simplistic. I do think that people who like historical fiction and want to read about someone surviving and overcoming traumatic events, this is one that you should take a look at if you're interested. So next, we went to Bree, which is The Prancing Pony, Drinks Come in Pints. Read a book that you are excited for. So for this, I chose Sword and Pen by Rachel Caine. So this is the fifth and final book in the Great Library series. So I thought it concluded nicely. So basically, I talked about this multiple times, but this is like an alternative world where the Great Library at Alexandria didn't burn down, and there's like a lot of, they're in control of all the world's books and written works, and there's like a lot of censorship going on, and our main characters are kind of like fighting against the library. So there were definitely like twists that I didn't anticipate in here. I don't want to give too much away since it is the final book in the series, but it's a lot about like what is best for the future, and like should the library survive as it is or does it need to change. So that was really fun. There is a scene that with one of the characters where he's kind of like Indiana Jones, and there's like, you know, solving puzzles and traps, so it reminded me a lot of The Last Crusade, which is really awesome. I definitely appreciated that. I thought this was, again, very fast-paced. I love this world. I highly recommend this series if you are interested in the premise. I think it's great. But yeah, it didn't end like I thought it would, and I appreciate that, you know? I always like being surprised by my books. So the next location is Weathertop. Frodo sees the Black Rider's true form. Read a book that's white under the dust jacket. So for this, I chose Berserker by Emmy Laybourne. So this is like the book that's like Little House on the Prairie meets Vikings. So this I rated 3.5 out of 5 stars. That was a really fun mashup. And like a really interesting premise. So basically in this world, certain families have bloodlines with various gifts. So like our main character, Hannah. Our main character is a berserker, and like her siblings have various other powers as well. Her dad has some powers. Our main character's abilities draws unwanted attention, basically, and they're forced to flee to America because they're trying to find their uncle, who is also a berserker, so he can, like, teach our main character how to get her powers under control. So we also have a main character, or our other, I guess, main character, Owen, is the bastard son of, like, a kind of well-off family, and he has left his home to be a cowboy and has a dog companion, Daisy, so that's always fun. So they like hire him to lead them to their uncle, and it's blizzard season, so like things don't go well, and like people are trying to track them down. It's obviously like about their journey, and our main character has like a lot of inner conflict because she obviously is not thrilled about some of these abilities, but she wants to protect her family. So there's definitely like some more sad and like thoughtful moments than I anticipated. I feel really bad for the main character. Her journey involved a lot of like, how do you stop hating yourself and your abilities? I thought it was a little predictable with some of the things that happened. Like there's a romance and, you know, I can see that. I saw that coming from a mile away, but I really liked it overall. Again, you know, the writing is a little simplistic, but that's okay. I thought it was a super fun premise. And I guess the sequel just recently came out, so I think I'm going to check it out. I really like this idea of these kids having various magical abilities, and I like the setting, so I definitely want to see where that goes. So next we have Rivendell. The Fellowship of the Ring is formed, and so you're supposed to read a book that features a squad, a group of friends, a family, a book club, etc. So for this I chose Star Wars Galaxy's Edge Black Spire by Delilah S. Dawson. So this I rated 4 out of 5 stars. So basically here we start off kind of before the events of episode 8, and then it, like, I mean, there's just like a very brief bit that starts before episode 8, and then we jump into the aftermath of things that happen. So I don't know how to pronounce our main character's name. It's like V-I, so I don't know if that's Vi or V. We'll just call her Vi. But she goes to Batuu to recruit for the Resistance, and she is joined by a droid and a former First Order captain. The relationship between her and this First Order captain is interesting. I'm not going to say more about that, just because you should discover it for yourself. Basically, yeah, so she's like trying to recruit people, and the First Order finds her, and you know, things, she has to survive that. So I thought the descriptions of this outpost were fabulous. Like, I thought it did a really great job at promoting this new Star Wars land area. Like, it really created some great descriptions of, like, things that people will want to buy and, like, you know, places that they'll want to visit while visiting this land. So, like, I had to laugh a little bit when I read some of these things. But I also was like, yeah, no, you did a really great job at this. I do want to buy these things and go to these places. I thought this was a really fun Star Wars book. I read it very quickly. I liked the main character a lot. I thought she was fabulous. I liked all the side characters too. There were some really interesting friendships that develop. There were definitely some like really funny moments, and you know, like I said, just this whole promotion of the new Star Wars land was just hilarious to me. But this is a really good Star Wars book, and I highly recommend it to anybody who wants to, you know, get into Star Wars books or enjoy Star Wars books. Like, definitely check this out. Prompt 5 was the Pass of Caradhras, so Frodo chooses to go through the Mines of Moria. Like, Frodo, your choice matters, read whatever you like. For this, I chose The Closed and Common Orbit by Becky Chambers, and I gave this 5 out of 5 stars. So, this is the second book in the Wayfarer series, and like, I don't want to obviously like spoil things that happen in the first book, but I will just say there's an AI in a human body who's like trying to adapt to this new situation, and we follow a couple of the main characters from the first book, and so this AI goes with one of these main characters to her home and like is kind of learning how to adapt to her body and like how to live. And so we learn more about, okay, I'll just say we follow Pepper in this, and she's the main character, one of the main characters from the first book. But so we learn more about Pepper's life growing up. And you know, we kind of see that she was originally created to do various tasks. So we like kind of alternate between Pepper's life growing up and then, our AI trapped in a human body as she's like trying to, you know, come to terms with what's happened. I think this was, I mean, obviously I loved it. It was great. I loved the characters. I was just like super invested in their journeys. I think it's really about like, it makes you think about AI's rights and like what it really means to be a person. I think it's about being comfortable in your own skin, and I loved it so much. Becky Chambers just has like a really great way of writing where you just care about the characters so much. I think it's kind of interesting. It's an interesting world where, you know, like, there's all sorts of genders and cultures that are, like, really accepted, but then people like don't really think of AI as being like actually people, so and they like think that they don't have rights. So I don't know. I think it's interesting to watch some of the characters kind of change their minds and like come to terms with like, oh, do I actually think that AI should have rights? So yeah, if you're looking for like a slice of life sci-fi book series that's very character driven and fantastic, I highly recommend this series. I love this. I really want to read the third book now. So then we have book six, which is The Bridge of Khazad-dûm. Gandalf confronts the Balrog, read a book with fire and or smoke on the cover. So I kind of cheated a little. This doesn't technically have fire or smoke on the cover. This is all shadow, but you know, the Balrog is like a creature of fire and shadow. So I was like, shit, I did this. I chose a good book here. But yeah, so obviously I read Dark Dawn by Jay Kristoff, which is the third and final book in the Nevernight Chronicles. So this is, you know, lots of revelations happen. Basically we follow our main character, Mia, who is on an epic revenge quest, and, we learn a lot of interesting tidbits about her and just, like, things that must happen. We deal with a lot of the fallout, obviously, from book two, and she is still seeking revenge, and she kind of has to choose a path between a revenge and, like, a greater goal. I didn't think it was quite as good as the others, but I still really enjoyed it. I thought it wrapped things up nicely. You know, there's pirates, lots of death. I was pleased with the ending. There's like fun moments because there's little footnotes throughout these books, and you like find out who wrote the books, which is kind of fun. I'm trying to keep this a little vague just to not spoil anything, but like I definitely didn't anticipate a lot of the twists that happen. I am very pleased with how it turned out. I think our characters deserve the ending that they got. I will say that. But yeah, like, I didn't really anticipate, like, this overarching goal, I guess, that happens in this book. But I thought it was a super cool touch. It's awesome. I definitely recommend this series. I don't think it's going to work for everybody. I will say, like, usually I'm not big on footnotes, but they worked for me in this series, but I don't think they worked for everybody. I don't know. I think they're fun. I think that my favorite is probably the second book, God's Grave, just because I really like books that deal with gladiator settings, and it was just, there was a lot of fun things that happened in that one. So then, location seven is Lothlorien. The Fellowship finds rest after escaping the mine, so this was like, read a book that's mostly pictures. For this, I chose The New 52 Aquaman Volume 1, The Trench. So this, we, like, kind of encounter the creatures from the trench, like, in the movie. Basically, they're searching for food to feed their queen, and Aquaman comes to the rescue, and there's, like, this piece of equipment, I think was part of an Atlantean ship that seems to lead Arthur to the desert, and, like, I think a lot of these aspects kind of come up in the new Aquaman movie. He, like, wants to eventually learn about the fall of Atlantis. So Mira is also there, and she's, like, kind of having trouble adjusting to human society. A lot of the designs, like, the creatures and stuff and, like, plot elements were similar to the movie, but it wasn't exactly the same plot, which was a little surprising to me, but I was okay with it. I rated this 4 out of 5 stars. I did enjoy it. I want to continue on and see what happens with it. I thought it was, like, kind of simultaneously funny and sad. There was a lot of jokes at Aquaman's expense. You know, people are like, you're the worst superhero, and I don't know. I mean, I like Aquaman, but I think a lot of people don't. So that was like, yeah, simultaneously funny and sad. I think there's like a crossover event with the Justice League, and I think a lot of that, I think that's like the Throne of Atlantis, so that may have more of a connection with the movie, or just like similar plot elements. But yeah, so I thought this was awesome. I want to show you, there's like these little baby, these are like the creatures from the trench and like a little sketch. And let's take a look at this little baby and the comment, their baby in a natural history museum, LOL. So yeah, I don't know. This was a fun Aquaman graphic novel. Definitely want to continue. Definitely recommend it, especially if you enjoyed the new Aquaman movie. So then we are at Emmenhen and the Fellowship is disbanded. Who do you follow? So I chose to follow Aragorn, Legolas, and Gimli, so I'm supposed to follow the orcs that took Merry and Pippin, read a book about a road trip. So for this, I read Stars Uncharted by S.K. Dunstall, and I rated this 3 out of 5 stars. We mostly follow two main characters. One of them, Josun, I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right, but she, like, infiltrates this captain's of the ship's crew, and her old ship is captured, and her, and, you know, bad things happen to the crew very early on in the book. And she, like, she's a junior engineer and has, like, a lot of high-level bioware. So the ship that Josun was, like, a part of and that they capture at the very beginning is, like, kind of a ship that explores the universe, I guess, and has, you know, it records its memory of all of its travels. So, you know, bad things happen. And then we also follow Nika, who is a body modder, and basically her ex-boyfriend, like, treats her really badly and kind of threatens her life. So she also, like, invented this device that, like, allows you to change bodies, so people are definitely after her because they want that. Follow them as they, like, all come together, and the goal basically was to, like, follow some of this information that the ship contained. I liked it, but it wasn't really what I anticipated, I guess. There was, like, a whole bunch of talk about body modification, like, you know, very heavy on the scientific, I guess, background behind it, and, like, specifically, you know, like, what chemicals do you need to use to do these things, and it's, you know, kind of involves different, like, fashions, you know, because body modders are kind of important and, like, really respected in this world. I think the problem that I had with this was that it, like, really wasn't about racing to this lost world. Like, I think that's going to happen more in, like, the second book, but I think it just, this was one that just, like, didn't quite live up to my expectations, or just, like, my expectations were a little skewed going into it. I did like the characters. I thought they were very interesting. I did like learning about this body modification in this sci-fi world. I don't know if I'm going to continue on, though. Like, I enjoyed it, but it wasn't the best sci-fi book I've ever read. So then, location 9, I went to Helm's Deep. So basically, we're, you know, like, fighting the battle at Helm's Deep, and they're losing hope, and so, the challenge here was to read a book that was 500 pages or more. So for this, I chose Seven Stones to Stand or Fall by Diana Gabaldon. This is a collection of Outlander short stories. So I rated this 3 out of 5 stars. So 5 of the 7 short stories in here have been previously published, and I've read a few of them before in different anthologies. There are 3 about John Gray, and they take place in, like, Canada, Jamaica, and Havana. And there's, like, various wars or sieges going on, and there's, like, some, you know, like, set in an actual historical background. There's a story about Jamie's younger stepdaughter. Basically, she's becoming a nun, but she also hears voices. There's a story about Roger's dad, which is actually kind of sad. He, you know, is a pilot and basically goes through the stones. And then there's a story about Ian and Jamie when they're younger, and a story about John Gray's brother and his eventual wife, I think, which, like, I did not remember her at all, so I was like, I don't really care about this story. Yeah, so some of these were pretty good, but overall, it wasn't my favorite. I focused on a lot of characters that, like, weren't as important to me. Like, I think the strong point of the Outlander, like, actual books is Claire, and she wasn't really in here at all, so, you know, like, I don't know. I just didn't quite care. I didn't connect as much with these characters. And like I said, like, particularly the one about John Gray's brother and his eventual wife, I did not remember those people at all. So John Gray is kind of an interesting character, and some of the stories were just okay, but the one that takes place in Jamaica, there's, like, this whole zombie aspect, which is kind of fun. That's probably my favorite story of the collection, and unfortunately that was one that I had actually read in a different anthology. But, you know, what can you do? I thought the story about Roger's dad was pretty interesting. Like I said, it's kind of sad, but that was maybe my second favorite. I don't know. As a whole, like, unless you're, like, super invested in learning about all the background of various side characters in Outlander, like, you could probably just skip this. I do like the Outlander main books, but, like, I will say, I've had this for almost a year, and, you know, there's probably a reason why I haven't picked it up before. I just, like, wasn't super excited about it, and it's kind of dense and, you know, takes a little bit to get through, but whatever. I still enjoyed it for the most part, so, you know, do with that what you will. So then the next location was the Pelennor Fields. So the Siege of Gondor claims many lives, read a book with an undead character. So for this, I chose Some Girls Bite by Chloe Neal. So I rated this 5 out of 5 stars. I just really, really enjoyed it. Basically, our main character, Merritt, is a graduate student, and she's attacked and turned into a vampire kind of against her will. So she, like, really has to learn the rules about being a vampire and learns about, like, all the supernatural creatures. There's, like, a little bit of a serial killer aspect or plot line introduced. So that was, you know, like, kind of a fun touch. She basically has, like, in this world, there are various vampire houses, and she kind of has to decide if she wants to work for these houses or not. So, like, in this world, this is an urban fantasy book, and we have witches, shifters, water nymphs, of, like, the rivers and, you know, other creatures. I thought this was really fun. I really enjoyed it. It is a little bit dated, I will say. I think this came out, this may be a reprint. Yeah, so I think this originally came out in 2009, but this may be, like, a reprint that came out a little bit later. But you can definitely tell it's, like, a little dated, just because mostly it, like, mentions things about, like, the Harry Potter books and movies and, like, the Lord of the Rings movies. But, like, specifically the most dated thing that I could think of was she was talking about, like, getting dressed and, you know, was like, oh, I'm gonna put on my low-rise jeans and layer some tank tops. And I was like, oh my god, that's hilarious, because, you know, like, I definitely remember back in around this time period, I also would layer tank tops and, you know, wear, like, a couple tank tops at a time with different colors and stuff. So that was just, like, kind of like a little nostalgia thing, and I just thought it was really funny. There's definitely a chosen one trope here, like, you know, she's special and has all these powers and, like, is going to be a very powerful vampire. So, like, you know, if you go into it knowing that and aren't bothered by this chosen one trope, I think you'll have a good time with it. I thought it was really fun. I liked Merritt quite a bit. I thought she was kind of a kick-ass main character. I liked her roommate. Definitely want to see where this goes. So I definitely am going to continue this series. I think it's a really fun urban fantasy with vampires. So location 11 is the Black Gate. So the rest of the Fellowship diverts Sauron's gaze to the Black Gate under the guise of a battle. We read a book that has a black cover. So for this, I chose Cold Iron by Miles Cameron. So this is like a coming-of-age story where the main character, like, was training as a mage, but he learns that he also has talent with the sword. So at the very beginning of the book, he is, like, heading home for the holidays and ends up killing somebody in self-defense. That's when he learns that he has talent with the sword, and so he, like, starts taking lessons to get better at that. And then he, like, starts to mingle with the city's elite, and there's, like, some politics involved. I rated this 2 out of 5 stars, so, like, unfortunately it didn't quite connect with me. It's definitely a classic fantasy type book where, you know, we have this typical story of, like, a farm boy or whatever learning and, like, going to school, and then he finds that he has a higher destiny. So I think, you know, the prologue was really interesting, and then I just got really bogged down. Like, I thought once we, like, actually started the book after the prologue, it just got off to a really slow start. I just was bored through most of this book. I don't know. I think it's kind of one of those things where the main character is, like, good at a lot of what he tries. And, like, I mean, obviously, like, I'm okay with that in some settings because, you know, like I mentioned in Some Girls Bite just now, like, it's another, like, chosen one trope where she's, like, awesome at everything. But it worked better for me there. Here, I don't know. I was just bored. I do think it's really interesting. So the main character comes from this lower class, like, background when he's a racial minority. So I think the book does address some of the, like, existing racism in this world, and I thought that was very interesting. You know, I thought he has some relationships with women that were, like, a little awkward to read about. But, like, generally as a whole, I do think he's a very, like, wholesome and main character, and he's, like, a really good person. You know, he wants to help his friends and do everything. But just generally, I don't know, I was a little disappointed. To be fair, I have had this on my TBR pile for a while and, like, haven't felt the urge to pick it up until now. So, like, I don't know. I guess I didn't have super high expectations of loving it. But it's still like a little disappointment that I was bored. I don't know. I think this is one that has a lot of very positive reviews, so like maybe I just didn't read it at the right time or something, but I would recommend, just because I didn't like it doesn't mean that you won't. So if this sort of story sounds interesting to you, I do recommend going to the Goodreads and just checking out the other reviews because they are mostly very positive. So yay, we're at the last location. So Gondor, we celebrate the return of the king, read a book that features a party. So for this, I chose Dating You, Hating You by Christina Lauren. So this is a lovers to rivals to lovers story. So our main characters meet at a party where they're kind of set up and, you know, they're the only single people at this Halloween party and they're both dressed as Harry Potter characters. They hit it off and then basically they work as agents in Hollywood, and so their firms merge together and they have to like basically compete for the same job. And they have to like simultaneously fight their attraction to each other. But they also kind of sabotage each other, but it's nothing like really malicious. They also help each other, which is fun. This kind of discusses some like really important issues like sexism in the workplace and like how people react to it and like, you know, what you can do to kind of alleviate some of these issues. So I definitely appreciated that aspect. I definitely like how these issues sort of resolve themselves. Basically, I just really loved it. I loved both of the main characters. Totally bought the romance. I believed in it. I believed in them and like was very satisfied with how this turned out. The female main character is like, you know, kind of a badass who works really hard for her job and like, I don't know, I just admire her. But yeah, so this was just like really funny and engaging. I read it in one day, so you know, really loved it. If you're a fan of this type of romance, I definitely recommend picking this up. I thought it was excellent. But yeah, so there are the 12 books that I read for the Lord of the Readathons. I did a pretty good job for the most part. I mean, there were a couple of books that I didn't love quite as much, but like, there were a lot of books that I did really enjoy. Let me know in the comments if you also participated in Lord of the Readathons, or if you've read any of these books, or think you might pick them up. I hope you're having an excellent day and are reading something awesome. If you enjoyed this video, feel free to give it a big thumbs up, as that would certainly help me out. But with that, I think I'm gonna wrap it up here and see you in the next one.